Welcome to the great Exodus years, God's plan of rescue for his children. Let my people go, the path to Mount Zion. My name is Michael. I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And our topic today is the Rose of Sharon. Who or what is the Rose of Sharon? Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is the Rose of Sharon. And if you become closer and closer to him, and you walk, act, and talk as he did when he was on earth, then you also become a small rose of Sharon. And the aim of the Lord is to establish as many places with these roses as possible. The roses of Sharon are part of the dwelling places of Zion. These roses are the elders that will lead these dwelling places. These are the special chosen ones who are walking very close to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who have access to the holy place in the spiritual, who are talking and walking with Jesus Christ, who are getting their direct instruction from our Lord and Savior. These are the roses of Sharon that you will see coming up in all the nations, in the dwelling places of Zion. Why? To testify of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and to set an example for all to see, and to bring forth a great light. And many people will be drawn to that light, and they will come forth, and they will be saved, and many people will come to righteousness. Many people will come to be the multitude clothed in white. Why? Because it is written in Revelation 6 that nobody could number the multitude. So a great revival will come, but only for the ones who separate themselves from the world, and only for the ones who repent and walk in obedience and walk with the Lord and take their cross and walk that narrow and righteous path towards Mount Zion, the holy mountain where we all will be raptured into paradise at the sixth seal. For the rest of the world, for the world and for Babylon, there will be great darkness coming. A new Pharaoh is on the way, the Antichrist, and his helper, the false prophet. And they will destroy the world, and they'll be worse than any other king before. Just imagine, more worse than Adolf Hitler, more worse than Pol Pot, more worse than Idi Amin, more worse than so many other examples. Now, a great new Pharaoh is coming. You must understand that when you remain in the world in your normal way that you do right now, then you will be in his hand, because his mark of the beast will control everything worldly. Your careers, your income, your banks, your riches, your families, your dependency on agencies or governmental agencies, the registration of cars, the buying of houses, all this will be regulated by the mark of the beast. So if you continue to stay in the world, then you have only one choice. If you want to not risk your eternal life, and that is to become a martyr. But the Lord is saying no. The Lord says, come out of the world and out of Babylon, and become a rose of Sharon. Establish a dwelling place of Zion in your neighborhood. Train and teach your disciples to be sent out so that they can bring in the great harvest of the ages. This is the time now. Thank you that you have listened. And I hope I give you a kind of inspiration. Think about it. Use discernment of all words that I speak forth. Take them in front of the Lord. Take them to heaven. Take them to the courts of heaven and see what you will receive in dreams and visions. Let us call forth all the roses of Sharon now into the nations, and let us establish the dwelling places of Zion, so that everything what is written will be fulfilled. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Maranatha.